Linda, just because Dr. Becker isn't here doesn't mean we don't work.
I'm working. I'm clearing out like 5 years worth of old magazines. Look at this. Fat Oprah, thin Oprah, fat Oprah, thin Oprah.
Keep one of each, then we're covered. Now get over here and help me with this filing.
Oh, come on, Margaret. Can't this be a me day? You know, a day to goof off while everyone else is working.
You do that every day.
Come on, Margaret. Let's just relax, kick back, read a magazine. Here's one now. What does it mean if your man chooses food over sex?
Linda, with Dr. Becker gone and no patients, this is a great chance for us to organize the office. What does it mean if your man chooses food over sex? So, I'm upstairs in bed waiting for Lewis. 10 minutes go by, 20 minutes go by. Finally, I go downstairs, and he is sitting by the door waiting for pizza.
Oh, you poor thing. So what did you say?
I said, Lewis, you placed 2 orders tonight, and one of them is about to get cold. Now, think about it. You can always reheat pizza.
So everything worked out okay?
Well, sort of. We had sex, but how should I put this? When we finished, the pizza was still hot. Why didn't you tell me you knew how to give pedicures?
Oh, when I worked in the beauty parlor, I got to do a lot of this. They wouldn't let me get near anybody's head.
Who do I know in Dallas?
Damn. Doctor's office.
Margaret, it's me. I'm stuck on a plane in Buffalo.
Don't ask. I need you to get me a phone number.
Well, it's a little tough right now. My hands are full.
Oh, well, maybe I should just sit on this plane for another 5 hours until your hands are empty.
Valium wear off?
Listen, I need to call a Dr. Tom Henshaw.
He's a plastic surgeon in Dallas.
All right, hold on a second.
Hi, Dr. Becker. We're working really hard here.
Put those down. He can't see you.
Oh, right. He has no idea we've been screwing around all day.
I do now.